Hi, and welcome back to my channel. So my name is Nienke de Glas. I'm a clinical researcher, mainly in oncology. And today I will discuss how you can adjust for confounding in epidemiological data. So before you watch this video, I'm assuming that you already know what a confounder is. So if you need a little refresher, please check out my previous video where I'm explaining this. So let's get started. So in this video, we will first discuss some ways that you can adjust for confounding. Then I will talk a little bit about how you can identify confounders in your own data. And finally, I will show you in SPSS how you can actually do this in real data. So if you remember my previous video, I was interested in the association between smoking and mortality, and dietary habits were actually a confounder for this association because people who smoke generally are more likely to have unfavorable dietary habits. So the first way that we can deal with confounding in this data is that we can stratify for the confounding variable. And that means simply just cutting your cohort in two, making a cutoff point for dietary habits. So you need to decide this is a healthy lifestyle and this is not. Then cut the cohort in two and look at the association between smoking and mortality within the two subgroups. That way you lose the effect of the confounding variable. This approach has some advantages, but also some important disadvantages. First of all, it's relatively easy. You can almost do this by hand, as you can imagine. And also, it allows you to look at the effects within different subgroups. And this is often very interesting because you might want to see within, for example, several racial groups or several age groups, what the effect of a determinant on your outcome is. So this might also be a reason to actually stratify your analyses. On the other hand, you actually lose a lot of power because you can imagine that if you create several smaller subgroups, of course, you have less power to find statistically significant results in your data. Also, it becomes more difficult when you have several confounders. And of course, this is often the case. So you can imagine that if you have multiple confounders, you will get many small and different subgroups, and it becomes almost impossible to really interpret the effect that you're actually studying. So a good alternative for stratifying is to use multivariate analyses. And you generally need some statistical software to do this. There are several advantages of this. You have a limited loss of power. It becomes more easy to combine several confounders in one model. So really study the interaction between all the several confounders that you might be interested in. And it's relatively easy to do when you have statistical software packages. So before you start your multivariate analysis, you actually need to think about what your possible confounders are. You will find many tutorials that will discuss how you can identify your confounders simply looking at your statistical output or enter several variables in your models. But there is an important pitfall there. Personally, I'm more a fan of really thinking about my data, deciding what confounders are before I do my analyses, and then deciding what my full multivariate model will be. And I will explain to you why I think that might be a better way. So let's get back to our previous example. If you remember from my previous video, we also discussed the effect of lung cancer. And you can imagine that smokers have a higher risk of getting lung cancer, and this might lead to mortality. So you might say that lung cancer is a confounding factor here. However, confounders can never lie in the causal pathway, and actually lung cancer is in between of the connection between smoking and mortality, and that makes that it's not a confounder. However, if you would simply look at your statistical model in this type of data, then you would see that the effect of smoking on mortality would dramatically change if you would enter lung cancer within that model. You might think, well, I have a confounder there, let's put it in my model. So that is why you need to study the possible relations within your data based on previous research that's already out there, because of course relations like these are often already known, in part at least. And if you would have done it in this case, you would already know that lung cancer is not a confounder, but it lies in the causal pathway, and that's why it should not be in your full model. So now let's take a look at some real data from my own research. So I'll put a link below in the description box where you can find the full paper, in case you're interested. But in short, this study investigated the association between age and getting a complication of breast cancer surgery. And you can imagine that with increasing age, there are several confounders that can arise here. So for example, comorbidity, which means having other diseases besides the breast cancer, can become important. And as a result of this, people use multiple medications, for example, blood thinners. And of course, you can imagine that this might increase the risk of complications such as bleeding. So let's take a look at the example of the confounding factors comorbidity and polypharmacy within the association between age and postoperative complications. So here you can see my simplified data set where I have an age category variable, surgical complications, polypharmacy and comorbidity. And before I start any analysis, I always like to take a simple look at my data. So let's go to the crosstabs command through Analyze Descriptives crosstabs, and then enter there the interaction between age categories and the two confounders that I'm interested in. Don't forget to check the row percentages. And also I want to do a formal statistical test, meaning the chi-square in this case. And usually I would always use the paste command because it allows me to save my syntax and then look at what I did in the next session. But for now I will simply press OK so we can take a look at the output directly. Let's enlarge this. So here we can see that indeed, when we get older, there is a larger risk of having polypharmacy, so meaning using more than 5 medications per day. This is statistically significant. And similarly, the chance of having multiple diseases besides breast cancer increases with age. It's what you would expect. So now let's take a look at what happens if we perform the actual analysis. So because I'm interested in the outcome, which is binary, either having a complication or not, I'm going to use binary logistic regression analysis. So regression, binary logistic regression. And here I will enter the dependent variable, which is having a surgical complication. And let's start by doing a univariate analysis, so entering age only as a covariate here. Because it's a categorical variable, we need to define it as such. So we go to categorical and enter it over here. And SPSS always uses the last category as a reference in the standard settings. I never tend to use that setting, I always change it to first, because in this case we're interested in the increasing age in comparison with the younger age group. So that makes sense to change it here. Then we will enter the 95% confidence intervals, because you need to report that in your manuscript, obviously. And we can again press OK here instead of paste, which I would usually do. And in this first model, you can see that indeed the chance of having a postoperative surgical complication increases with age. So now let's go back and see what happens if we enter a possible confounder in our model. So we can do this two ways. We can either use this tab right here, which allows you to go back to previous windows, or we can go the way we went there before, so Analyze Regression Logistic Regression. Now we enter the extra covariate comorbidity. It's also a categorical variable, so we will change it here, and we change the reference category, and we press OK again. Now you have a model with age in it, which is adjusted for comorbidity. And you can see that the odds ratios here have slightly changed. So there is a little bit of an interaction between age and comorbidity in this model. So now let's look at the second confounder. We will additionally add it here. We go back this way this time, logistic regression. And then adding polypharmacy here. It's again a categorical variable, obviously. Change and then press OK. And there you have it. This is your full multivariate model for the association between age and complication outcome after breast cancer surgery, adjusted for comorbidity and polypharmacy. It's just as simple as that. And in your manuscript, you can choose to report either the full model, so all the odds ratios for the different variables, or you can simply report age with the notification that it's adjusted for comorbidity and polypharmacy. Both ways are correct. So now let's take a look at the other way that we can deal with confounders in our data, meaning stratifying. And in this example, I will only stratify for the variable of polypharmacy. Because it is only a binary variable, it's a bit easier for this example. And we can again do this in two ways. So if we go back to the regression window where we previously were, we press here. Now we remove polypharmacy here, obviously. And we will enter it here as a selection variable. And what SPSS does is, if you enter a selection variable here, it will only perform the analysis up here within the category that you have defined here. So you will need to tell SPSS in which category you want to perform this analysis. So in this case, in my data, having a zero for polypharmacy means that there's no polypharmacy. So I will simply press zero here, then press OK. And now you have a model for the association between age and complications within the group of people without polypharmacy. And this analysis is even adjusted for comorbidity. So you can immediately see that it's even possible to combine the two strategies of stratifying and adjusting your data. So now if we would want to report the outcomes in the other group, obviously we would simply change the rule here to 1, which means having polypharmacy in my data set. Press OK. And you can see that the odds ratios here are now different. The second way to do this, and this is especially helpful when you have several analyses that you want to stratify, is to split your whole cohort into groups. And I will show you how that works. You go to Data, then Split File, and you press here Organize Output by Groups. And this means that after you've entered this, SPSS will stratify everything that you do after this in the groups that you've defined. So when we enter polypharmacy here, you will see that you get two outputs for every analysis that you do afterwards. So now we can go back again to the logistic regression tab. We will remove polypharmacy here, obviously, otherwise SPSS will get confused. And we press OK. And now you will see here on the left side that there are more than one analysis. Here you can see polypharmacy 0 and here polypharmacy 1. And of course, the output will be exactly the same as in the way that we previously did it. So to sum up, the two most common ways to adjust for confounding in your data are to stratify your analysis or to perform multivariate analysis. And never forget here to think about the associations within your data instead of simply only looking at statistical interactions. So thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. And I would also be really interested to hear what you think. Also, if you have any additional questions or specific topics that you would like me to discuss in any upcoming videos, please leave me a comment below and I will do my best to answer all your questions.